Marcus Svensson från The Tarantula Waltz. I guess it was this myth, Italian myth about the spider. If you get bitten by the spider, the tarantula, then you have to dance this special tarantula waltz, or it's not a waltz, but it's some kind of freaky dance to get the poison out of the blood. And I think that was the reason I chose that name. But it's a very complicated name, and most people don't remember it after hearing it once. So I always have to tell them that story to make them remember the name. It's very uncommercial, I guess.
This is really all there is. Strive, strive, and one day you just quit.
I don't I think this is my fourth album, and in the beginning it was just me, and then lots of different musicians played with me. These guys playing with me now have been playing with me last 5 years, maybe two albums, one EP, and I guess they will continue playing with me, hopefully. But the band, I guess, is me. Every year we turn more and more into a real band, including those guys.
Give up. This fat you cannot wear. Your brain. I hear you falling apart.
Yeah, maybe. I guess if I would to sit down and read all my lyrics, I would find maybe two or three themes. At the moment, I think it's I find my son and my daughter in lots of the lyrics. And when I sing on stage, I think a lot about them. So I guess they are always there somehow. At the moment, or this last 3 years, my kids are the theme for my lyrics.
Refuse to play the game. Honesty doesn't lead to fame. Karen Dalton. Such a shame. When death came, didn't I write your name in gold? Did not give it a rock and roll.
Stockholm. Solna, very close to Stockholm. Yeah, I know, and I should have come up with an answer for this question. Should have 10 years ago, but. I would say it's what's the word for gubbrock in English? Heartland rock with satanistic heartland rock with a feministic touch. Yeah.
Didn't I write your name in gold? No, didn't I give it a rock and roll? Hello.
This last album recorded in Dubious Studios with producer Christopher Roth. He's like indie legend. He's recorded loads of great Swedish indie albums, and I love working with him. He's so easy to work with and just a great music loving person. A big heart, and I really want to record with him again.
I should
just started planning how to record and where to record new songs. And new songs are coming now, and I can feel songs are in me somewhere, so they need to get out. It feels good, but this last album did pretty good for being us. So slowly lifting, I feel, we just keep doing what we do anyway. And next up is a little bigger show in Stockholm. We will do with a couple of friends, and guests on stage. That will be very, very special night, I think. I look forward to that in February next year. And I don't know, maybe before that we record new songs, and then we'll see when those songs get out there. Hellsaden. Nah, I don't know. There's a feminist revolution going on. I love that. And I want to be a part of that. I think you should too. Yeah, great.